الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الأنفال chapter الأنفال in the verse number 2 أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون أولئك هم المؤمنون حقا لهم درجات عند ربهم ومغفرة ورزق كريم. So three ayat. So the first ayah, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِنَّمَا أَدَاتُ حَصْرٍ مِنْ أَدَوَاتِ الْحَصْرِ إِنَّمَا it means these are the believers and only these. It's a tool, إِنَّمَا to, it means exclusivity. These are exclusively the believers. Anyone else is not. Who are they? And Allah then describes them. إنما المؤمنون الذين the first description الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم so criteria number one when Allah's name is mentioned their hearts are fearful they are in awe their hearts tremble to the remembrance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم أي خافت تعظيما وإجلالا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when they hear the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their heart, they feel something in their heart. And this feeling of awe, of fear, of ta'zeem lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the fruit of the iman. That's an indication of the iman of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the more we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more that feeling of awe, of khashya, of fear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes intense. And why not? Why not should our hearts tremble to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَهُوَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ بِيَدِهِ حَيَاتُكَ وَمَوْتُكَ وَبِيَدِهِ سَعَادَتُكَ وَشَقَاءُكَ وَبِيَدِهِ جَنَّتُكَ وَنَارُكَ Everything in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, if we just remember one thing, if just we remember the day we are called in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah is going to order us to Jannah, نسأل الله subhanahu wa ta'ala ذلك, or to نار, نسأل الله subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يعافينا. If we just remember that, one day we'll stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's going to order us to Jannah or to Nar. And in either case, it won't be وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا So if we just remember that, it should make our hearts tremble. So that's the first criteria. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ That's number one. Number two, وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا And when the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are recited to them, it increases them in faith. It increases their faith. Alhamdulillah, wallahi, we're blessed with our beloved Shaykh Muhammad. Yani, when you hear the recitation in Salat al-Fajr, in Salat al-Isha, does it increase my iman or I'm somewhere else? In my bills and in my grocery. So do I feel every day when I hear the ayat that my iman is increasing? So that's the second indication of iman. The third, وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ And they rely, they put their trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, they do what they have to do. They exercise the asbab. They do their part, but their heart reliance is on the ends, is on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ Three criteria. And then the fourth, الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ So the first three ones are deeds of the heart. They are not physical activities. So the first one, we said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَجَلُوا الْقَلْبِ. This is a deed of the heart. It's not physical. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُ إِيمَانًا. Again, this is also in the heart. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. Also in the heart. So these are three مقامات, three أحوال, and three stations of the heart. And the last two are actually physical, because once the heart is full with iman, once the heart is full, hears the ayat and increases in iman, once the heart is putting its trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, automatically it will show outside. And you cannot tell, oh, you have iman, alhamdulillah, my iman is strong, I believe in Allah, I love the Prophet, but I don't pray. No, you're lying. The iman will show automatically. There is no way around it. So, وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. So the first one, يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. They establish the prayer. And the scholars, they said, يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ means they do it in time. They do the due diligence when they do their wudu. They do their ruku'ah the right way. They do their sujood the right way. They take their time. They don't rush it. So that's iqam salat. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. And the fifth criteria, they spend from that which we provide to them. And this includes zakat and includes all types of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are five criteria. So if I want to know how is my iman, we always wonder, right? What is my iman? Nowadays, you can go to Quest Diagnostics. They take a sample of your heart, of your blood, sorry. And 2 days, they give you two pages, all your numbers. Your cholesterol is low, or is high. Your this is low. This is critically high. You need to put your own medicine. So I wish we had something like that for our iman. You go, they take, oh, your riya is very high. We need to get on medicine on riya. Your sincerity is really low. We need to put you, we need to take care of. So we don't have that yet, but we have these five criteria. So every believer, if you want to see where is your iman, then measure it against these five measurements. إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. And then the ayah concludes, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقًّا. These are the true believers. لَهُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. They have high ranks. They have high positions in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a generous, honorable provision on the day of judgment. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى رب العرش العظيم أن يجعلنا منهم. اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك الذين إذا ذكرت وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.